question here then. So looking at it in detail, we need to identify the main benefits DCS will gain from engaging in detailed strategic planning approach. And also we have another little extra there to identify any potential drawbacks of such behavior. So there's the question, and the all important thing is there are 10 marks. So when we see 10 marks, does that mean anything to you? Well, if it doesn't, it should, because when I see 10 marks, I think, well, how many minutes is that? It's really important that we manage our time in this exam and we get used to this right from the start. So how long is the exam? You know it to be 4 hours, which is 240 minutes. You're probably going to spend about 40 minutes reading all the exhibits and the requirements and thinking about what you're going to say. So that takes 40 minutes out of 4 hours. So that leaves you with 200 minutes. 240 minutes minus 40 minutes leaves 200 minutes. And also remember that the exam, although it's 100 marks, has 20 professional marks, which we've talked about, and it takes no time to acquire these professional skills marks. They are marks that are awarded for how we develop our answer. So when we're working out the time, we're going to think about 200 minutes. We're not going to divide it by 100. We're going to divide it by 80. And if you do that sum, you should come up with 2.5 minutes per mark. So just to remind you, we've got 10 marks at 2.5 minutes per mark. That would be 25 minutes. So all this planning, though, actually has some impact. I would then suggest that whatever time you're starting this question, you write it down, and then you add 25 minutes to your start time, and you write down your finish time. Yeah, so that's the time you've got to actually deliver your answer. But let me talk a little bit about how I would suggest you go about planning this particular answer. First thing we think we need to do is we need to do a brainstorm. Once we've done that brainstorm, we can then do a mark-focused plan. So if we think back to the question, we're asked to identify the main benefits that DCS will gain from engaging in detailed strategic planning and identify any drawbacks of that behaviour. So if we first of all think about what is the knowledge area that this particular question is examining. Questions don't always examine a particular knowledge area, but that's the first port of call I would think about. And hopefully you recognize this is about planning. It's about why do we do planning? Why don't we do planning? And in that area, you should have some generic knowledge if you have absorbed the notes I've given to you. And if I think about why plan, what would I think? Well, I would think about crumpet, focus, and finance. So that's just all the knowledge I know about why a generic company would plan. And I would also have a good idea about maybe why not, why wouldn't I plan? And that's probably to do with time, cost, inflexibility, the external environment might be too dynamic, or maybe just general management.